Welcome back to our Proactive London studio. I'm delighted to be joined now by the CEO and Executive Director, Michael Law, and the Non-Executive Director, Ajay Rajpal, both from RC365 Holding PLC. Gentlemen, a very warm welcome to you. And Michael, you listed the company here in London last March, so perhaps you'd like to start by telling us how it's been going so far.
Yeah, the company going so far so good. And actually, we merged three companies into RC365, which is that our country coverage will become much more, not just only in Hong Kong, but also like in Singapore and in UK. And also from the point of view, that we upgrade our system to RC 2.0. And we have a new project has been going like to do more ERP solutions for the corporate and the individuals. Yeah.
Understood. Well, it's obviously been going well enough for you to receive quite a few awards over the last year. So perhaps you'd like to give us a rundown of those.
Yeah, we got three trophies since last July from the Hong Kong Most Outstanding Leaders Awards 2022. And the HKMVC, the most valuable company, and the last one is the Hong Kong Commercial Times Business Award. Yeah. So these three awards really bring the company have a big recognition from the world. Yeah.
Fantastic. Thank you, Michael. Turning to you now, AJ. Let's hear a little bit more about your role in the business and what you think that investors can expect from the coming months.
Sure. Hi. I'm non-executive director. I joined the company shortly before its listing last year. And I've pretty much been providing typical non-executive director services. I have been providing the board with sort of advice and guidance in a generic basis. I've been also providing sort of challenge and scrutiny to some of the plans that they have and some of the proposals they put forward. I've also been helping with their transition from a private group to a publicly listed group with all the sort of the corporate governance and policies and procedures that involves. And I must say they've taken to that very well. We've spent 9 months really bedding down and I think the team, credit to the team, they've taken to it very well. Moving forward, we have our year end coming up on the 31st of March, so our annual results will be out on or before 31st of July. We're hoping to continue the growth that we've experienced in the company over the last few years. Separately to that, we're working on a number of growth initiatives, which we hope we can hopefully conclude in the short order.
Yep.
These are ongoing initiatives, so we do have aggressive growth plans. We're looking to, obviously bed down the Asian operations and bolt on sort of UK, Europe and wider.
Fantastic. Oh, well, plenty for you to update us upon before long, I'm sure. But turning back to you now, Michael, is there anything that you think investors need to understand better about RC365?
Actually, we are transforming the payments fintech solutions and transform the company into the full coverage of fintech. What means full coverage? It is not just only the payments, but also we do like what we just mentioned, the ERP solutions and the card solution services. So it can be really, cover the whole fintech idea, okay, of the whole transform and upgrade for the customers in the coming future. So I do looking forward to bringing more new people coming in and expand the teams in the UK and Europe side and as well as in Asia. Yeah.
Great. Well, very best of luck to you and to you as well, AJ. And thank you both very much for coming into our London studio today.
Thank you.
Thanks.